But then it has its own limitations.
Absolutely.
Like, have you seen a student who has topped the board in 10th class, topping again in the 12th class?
I haven't seen. Actually, even the research doesn't say that.
Yeah. So why are you trying for that? In fact, the schools must try to give all kind of this.
Recently, research on CBSC results has been published. I was in one of the sessions with CBSC chairperson, and he shared it with all the principals. 10th class, those students who have taken school-based exam, not the board-based, they have excelled in 12th board. And those who have done very good in 10th board-based exam, they've done very low in that 12th board. So he shared the data, and it was really a big difference in those graphs. It was amazing.
But the children who are here in the US, that we prepare them for the SAT, ACT exams?
Yeah, SAT exam.
Okay. So they have a little bit of a different curriculum than the kids who are going to be here?
No, normally what's the main thing, that SAT exam, whatever SAT exams are taken up, CBSC curriculum is very, very much matching with
that
curriculum. So they are quite comfortable
taking the SAT.
Yeah.
But you don't offer SAT here, you have to go back to US to do
We already have our guests with us. The chief guest, the guest of honor, are already there. Yes, the class must go on.
Come on.
We are welcoming them. Let's give a warm welcome.
We have amidst us the Joint Commissioner.
Yes, the Joint Commissioner of Police, Mr. V.M. Parghi and Mr. Ashok Parikh.
Our guest of honor.
Top management, a highly active PSA food and hostel committee members, and of course, last but not the least, our diligent teachers and the staff members. Today we have gathered here for a beautiful cause. We all know that to donate is not the virtue of hands, but it is the virtue of heart. Like in all other aspects of life, G.D.Goenka International School keeps itself abreast and believes in the virtue of giving.
This is the third consecutive year where the school is organizing the blood donation camp, because we believe that the blood is red gold in time of saving life. Blood donation is the blessed are those who can give without expecting anything in return. Our mentor and guide, Sri Manar Kakaria, is blessed with such a boon. And so, every year, we at GDGIS hold this righteous cause and donate blood in bulk. Almost all the staff members and our esteemed parents willingly donate their blood and are responsible for saving
new. Gauri Sutaya Ganana Namo Namaste. Gauri Sutaya Ganana Namo Namaste.
That was blissful. We start all those auspicious occasions with the blessings of Lord Ganesha. So, for this pious event, we now call upon our chief guest, the guest of honor, and the top management for the lighting of the lamp. Can we have the lamp lighting, please?
This most persistent and urgent question is, what are we doing for others? We are not here for a happy material life, but we are here for selfless service and shelter. And when the action is pure and selfless, everything settles into its own perfect places. Just like the wick of the diya burns itself to illuminate the surrounding, likewise, we need to selflessly render our services to the people who are in need.
By enchanting the name of Lord Ganesha, all our troubles flee away. We also lighten the lamp for enlightening our minds. But today, performing this ritual is special, as the selfless deed of donating blood shall brighten the lives of many. Put your hands together as we have this lamp lighting ceremony.
The most traditional. Felicitate Mr. V.M. Pargi, and I also request Ms. Niyati Tandel to escort the two gentlemen to the dais. Class must go on. Well, we are very privileged to have such a dignified personality amongst us, Mr. V.M. Pargi.
Can we hear it? He deserves a louder applause, everyone.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir.
We also have amongst us today's guest of honor, Mr. Ashok Parekh, the Chief Manager Operations, Surat Raktadan Kendra. Let's now watch the amazing journey of such a versatile dignitary.
Mr. Ashok Parekh, Chief Manager Operations at Surat Raktadan Kendra, an astute professional with experience in retail operations, sales, marketing, and business development, worked with Walgreens chain of stores USA as assistant manager from 1999 to 2009. A keen planner with proven abilities in devising strategies to augment business, streamlining distribution networks, promote products for business excellence. Defy in analyzing business potentials, conceptualize and execute strategies to drive sales, augment turnover, and achieve desired targets. Demonstrates abilities in corporate communication, image, and brand building. An effective communicator with excellent relationship building and interpersonal skills. Well, he also deserves a big round of applause here. And now may I request the Vice Principal Ma'am, Ms. Jayashree Churariya, to felicitate Mr. Ashok Parikh, and I also request Ms. Nandini Chetri to escort them to the dais. Yes, here we have Mr. Ashok Parikh with us. We're very proud to have him here right now. It should be a huge round of applause, please. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. And we also have with us Ms. Sejal Jhaveri, the daughter of Ashok Parikh. So, ma'am, if you can please come on the stage. I request our Assistant Director, Mr. Pranay Jardosh, to escort and felicitate. And I request Nandini ma'am, Niyati ma'am, to escort them. Sejal Jhaveri here, please. Have it for her.
Hear it for them, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. We also have amidst us our esteemed parents as special guests. We now request Ms. Sejal Thakur to please escort the parents of the primary section. We have with us Mr. Prashant Uttam Chandani and Mrs. Jia Uttam Chandani, parents of Vedant Uttam Chandani of the first A. We have Dr. Anjana Meena and Dr. B.S. Meena, parents of Abhilasha of Standard 4. And we have Kamaldeep Singh Grover and Mrs. Puneet Kaur, parents of Ansh Govind Singh, 3rd A. May I request Mrs. Seema Khanna to please come and felicitate?
You may stand facing the audience, sir, ma'am, please.
Mrs. Seema Khanna, please, the coordinator of the primary section.
Yes, they are our valuable parents. A special guest for the day.
Can we hear it for them?
Section in front of the stage. May I please call upon Jignesh Desai and Binal Desai, the parents of Ash Desai, right in front of us. I may also request Sri Prakash Rathi and Sangeeta Rathi, the parents of Garima Rathi, to come in front of the stage. And I request Kedar Jagirdar and Deepa Jagirdar, the parents of Mansi Jagirdar, to please come in front of the stage. Ashok, and of course, Sonia Bengani, the parents of Chad Bengani. And I request the coordinator of the middle section, Richa ma'am, to do the honors.
May I also request Mr. Ankur Tulsian and Mrs. Kavita Tulsian, parents of Kashvi Tulsian of first C, to please come ahead. Can we hear it for the parents, please?
Clap should go louder, I don't know. Where's the energy? Come on, teachers and the parents. Yeah, we may also call upon Miral Nayak and Urvi Nayak, the parents of Slok Nayak. Please, you may also join the doctor who gave us a lot of information, the parent of today. Yes. Thank you very much. Thank you, ma'am. All right. Now we request our guest of honor, Mr. Ashok Parikh, to express his views on this propitious event. Sir,
please. Mr. Ashok Parikh, please.
Good morning to everybody. Good morning. Respected Principal, Vice Principal, Chief Guest, Mr. Pagi, parents, teachers, and the guests. It gives me a great pleasure and privilege to be invited on this august audience, and particularly a premier and prestigious institute of G.D.Goenka International School. I'm really honored and grateful for making my presence here on such a noble and humanitarian cause. Next few minutes, I just would like to address this issue of blood donation, because after my joining a Surat Rakhtadan Kendra, I feel that there are few issues which has to be addressed, and I am just trying to explain to you through a basic question of how, why, what, through this few minutes talk. Let us ask first question, why there is a blood donation? One of the reason for blood donation is that there is no factory of blood anywhere in the world. Scientists have tried, but so far they are not successful in creating blood in the factory. So that is the first limitation, that there is no factory. The second, there is no other source of blood. Even the animal cannot give a blood to the human being. So that is the second limitation. Like milk can be provided by the animal, chicken, buffalo, all can be taken for a food, but blood cannot be taken from the animals to the human being. So the fact is that only human being can give blood to human being. And therefore, since there is no alternative, human is depending on another human's humanitarian act of donating blood. Now, it is not possible that all human blood can be compatible with other human. And therefore, this has to undergo a process. Like in dairy, the milk is being taken, it is pasteurized and made fit for consumption of human being. Same way, the blood also has to be processed. And therefore, there is a need for a blood bank to process your blood, keep it ready when there is an emergency. So, we are 100% depending on one human being to another human being as far as the blood supply is concerned. We also cannot have a board that anybody can come and give a blood and we'll pay them 300, 400 rupees. The blood cannot be bought as a law. So this has to be voluntarily blood supply. And in 1998, the Melbourne Convention has made it mandatory that only voluntary blood donation is to be achieved by 2020. Therefore, Government of India has also made a lot of efforts to ensure that safe and quality blood is being given through a blood bank. And therefore, blood cannot be purchased, it has to be voluntarily given by another human being. And that requires a lot of efforts to collect the blood from voluntary donors. Therefore, since we cannot buy the blood, we depend on various schools, colleges, factories who prepare their employees or their members to come forward and give a voluntary blood to us. Fortunately or unfortunately, the trend is increasing, but still there is a big gap between supply and the demand. Take example of Surat city, which is having a 55 lakhs population and probably 30 lakhs can give a blood. Even we find difficulties to get 0.3%. 30 lakhs if they give a blood to us, there is no possibility of any shortages. But we continuously face shortages of blood because there is a big gap between supply and demand. And therefore, it has to be a social awareness that people come forward and give a blood to us. What was there for 15 years? Yes, there was much difficulties. There is a lot of awareness is being created, but there is a lot to be done. And therefore, I am here to appeal all students and the parents to make blood donation as a lifestyle. It cannot be made mandatory. Therefore, it has to come from within that I must give a blood to save a life for others. I request students or the parents that make it a life mission that at least once in a year, whether it is your birthday, whether it is your parents' birthday or your guru's birthday, you make sure that you give a blood. Now, blood donation can be given through two means. One is the blood donation camp, which probably today you will be able to do it. But we have made another facility that individual can come to our blood bank and devote just 30 minutes round the clock, 365 days. Anytime you can walk in, even at midnight, if you feel like to give a blood, we are ready to receive that blood. So use that opportunity as an individual, that today is your birthday, you go to temple, we have no problem. You go to church, we have no problem. But after going to church or temple, find 30 minutes to come to our center and be ready to give blood. If this trend increases, then the supply and demand gap will be narrowed down. Last but not least, you don't know who will need a blood. Today we are fine, tomorrow we unfortunately meet with an accident, we need a blood. So there is no address written on any blood bag. Anybody is a potential candidate, and therefore it has to be very seriously looked into the lifestyle of that once in a year you would like to give a blood to us. Encourage children, when they turn 18, they should give a blood. Surat Raktadan Kendra is extending service since 37 years. It's a non-profit organization. We give 1,57,00,000 worth of blood free to the needy patients of Smimer Hospital, Civil Hospital, and thalassemia patients. We don't charge a single rupee for a thalassemia patients. So a lot of charity is being done, and we depend on the donors of blood as well as the money board. I congratulate the management of G.D.Goenka International School for organizing this event, which is a great human cause, and I'm sure this will continue or maybe increase with the cooperation of the patient parents association, that it should go to twice or thrice. We have maximum problem during the month of May and October, November, where we have an acute shortage of blood, where the demand is increasing, the supply is decreasing because people are enjoying a vacation, and therefore our supply goes down. And therefore, these are the months where if anybody can come walk into our centers, they are most welcome. Once again, thank you for your invitation and good luck to you.
Thank you so much, sir. That was indeed very informative, and we are the fortunate ones who, just you said, like in the month of May it's less, and we are here in the month of May to donate all the blood. So that was great. And it, just like you said, sir, you can donate blood 168 times between the age of 18 to 60 years. So you can imagine the number of lives that you're going to save.
And
wow.
Can you imagine the importance of the blood It is rightly said in the beginning that when a child is ill, the mother can only cry for it. A mother's cry cannot save the life, but our blood surely can. We don't know where our blood will be utilized, but it will be definitely utilized for something good. So definitely it's a wonderful cause that we are here for.
And now we have a small video clip depicting the importance of blood donation.
भर्ती हर 10 व्यक्तियों में से एक को रक्त की आवश्यकता है। इस हिसाब से हमें हर दिन 38,000 रक्तदाताओं की आवश्यकता है। इसका मतलब हर 2 सेकंड में किसी न किसी को रक्त की जरूरत है।
हेलो,
मैं आपको थैंक यू कहना चाहती हूँ।
थैंक यू, किस लिए?
वो एक्चुअली मुझे ना थैलेसीमिया है। और हर महीने आप जैसे अंकल आंटी खून देते हैं और मेरी मदद करते हैं, पर मुझे पता नहीं वो कौन है, इसलिए सबको थैंक यू बोल देती हूँ। सो थैंक यू।
पर बेटा, मैंने तो कभी ब्लड डोनेट किया ही नहीं।
कोई बात नहीं, नेक्स्ट टाइम के लिए। बाय
बाय। 18 साल की उम्र से रक्तदान करें, ये किसी की जिंदगी बचा सकता
है। करके देखो,
अच्छा लगता है।
Well, that was indeed very touchy. The last clip, really, the goosebumps were on for me.
Okay, now that we have some special guests with us, would anyone of you like to share your views on blood donation or blood? Anybody? Our special guests? Anyone would like to say something? A few words?
The parents?
Anyone?
A few words, maybe.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
My name is Shiv Rathi, parents of Garima Rathi. Everybody, good morning. जैसा कहते हैं कि रुका हुआ पानी गंदा हो जाता है, चलता हुआ पानी क्लीन रहता है, वैसे अगर आप ब्लड डोनेट करते रहेंगे तो नया ब्लड बनेगा, वो अच्छा क्लीन बनेगा और उसमें आपका स्वास्थ्य भी अच्छा रहेगा। और दूसरा, अगर कॉमेडी में कहा जाए सबको हंसाने के लिए, तो हस्बैंड को तो वैसे ही डोनेट कर ही देना चाहिए। थैंक यू।
दैट वाज वेल सेड।
थैंक यू सर।
एनीवन एल्स?
ओके,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग मैम। एस सर राइटली सेड वी शुड डोनेट, द ऑल हस्बैंड शुड डोनेट। आ हा, बट as I said earlier, there are no, and the sir has given us all the information that at all the part of the body, we can donate only at the end of our life, but the blood we can donate when we are alive. And it goes to whom and when we are blessed, we don't know. And whatever the blood that we donate, normally it gets reformed within less than a week. But ideally, every 3 months that we should donate. When we donate, there are a couple of precautions to be taken, that you take a light snake, don't drive immediately after you have donated the blood. You take a rest for 5-10 minutes once you feel comfortable. And other than that, it does not affect your life. In my personal opinion, I have donated a couple of times, and then immediately after that, we have done long hour surgeries as well. And you're always comfortable. So we are not losing, but we are gaining the blessings of so many people. And whosoever we have never donated till now, but still we have another 5, 6, 7 years more left to donate, because we may be able to donate till 42, couple of age. So this is a lot of learning that school has taught to us, whosoever has not done till now. And we are thankful to school for giving us an opportunity to donate. Thank you.
Very well, sir. These words are certified, because the parent is a doctor. So I guess all of you are convinced and inspired, and make sure we all donate whoever we can.
And that was really very informative as well, ma'am.
Okay, so there's one very good information we'd like, since nowadays everyone is so health conscious. We'd like to share one thing with you. Sir, could you tell me what's your blood group?
It's O positive.
You're thinking, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. It's O positive.
Okay. What do you like to eat?
I like to eat, should I say the truth?
Okay. Absolutely.
Yes, of course. Burgers, pizzas, kachoris, puris and all.
Well, I think that shows. But hold on, sir. Could anyone please tell me what was common and uncommon thing in his menu? Junk food. Okay, anybody else? No, sir, you don't need to talk now. Yes? Fried food, junk food, anything else? A lot of carbs. See, health conscious people talking. Anyone else? Okay, let me go on then. In that case, if you noticed, the common thing is that the food items, let me remind you, he said burgers, pizzas, cakes, kachoris, puris. So the food items are all round in shape. And
hold on,
it's okay, it shows, relax. And the uncommon feature is the shape of the blood, of the food resembles the type of his blood. And to add on to it, so does his circular physique.
I'll have to check my blood group again. I'll test.
I thought he gave me the right answer.
There is some problem, I guess. Finally, leave it. If it is O positive, what has my puris and kachoris to do with my blood group?
You got a point, sir. Well, I can clarify, I can justify this. The food group is connected to the blood type. Eating food just for filling the stomach is blind eating. So, here are a few points which shall guide you to the correct selection of food to be consumed. If you are having the type O blood, you can diet on your lean meat, poultry, fish, fruits, vegetables, limit grains and dairy, and exercise vigorously. Have you even thought of jogging?
Yes.
Okay, I'll get you. Type A, should eat soya foods, grains, organic vegetables, and do gentle exercise. That's me, I do my yoga. Type B, should eat dairy foods, meat, corn or wheat, and do moderate exercise, but please no beans. Type AB, should eat seafood, tofu, dairy, limit chicken, beef, pork, and do calming exercise. So you could, did anyone even think of it that you're supposed to eat food as per your blood type? I don't think many of us are even aware of it. Well, we all need to get onto our internets and surf through that.
Enough of informations now, ma'am.
Yeah, I know, I attacked you, sorry.
Blood relation questions, how about it?
Well, that sounds good. Khoon ka rishta. We always talk about blood. So, are we all ready to face a few questions? Sir, if we have the time. Yes, sir. Okay, thank you so much. That was wonderful. Can we have the quiz questions, please?
Okay, these are very simple questions. You don't have to really stress too much on your brain. But then still, you need to answer.
No, don't stress your brain. Just tax your brain a bit. Okay, we have the first question. Pointing to a photograph of a boy, Suresh said, "He is the son of the only son of my mother. How is Suresh related to that boy?" Your options are brother, uncle, cousin or father. Please take your time, take your time and give me the right answer. We are teachers, we might just land up punishing you. Take your time. Think over. We are fresh enough to think.
Right, should I give a try? He is the son of the only son of my mother.
So let them think. Teachers, can we wait? Any of the parents first?
Father.
You sure, ma'am? Could you explain it?
No.
Well, if there's a confident answer, you need to explain it, ma'am.
He is the son of the only son of my mother. The only son of my mother is me. And my son, obviously, father.
Ma'am, don't get jittery. You are correct. Please give a huge round of applause. She got the correct answer.
That was a tricky one, actually. Mujhe malum tha answer aisa kuch
nahi. I know that. Can we have the next question, please? Introducing a boy, a girl said, "He is the son of the daughter of the father of my uncle. How is the boy related to the girl?" Your first option, brother, nephew, uncle or son-in-law. Think over, it's a pretty twist question.
Don't give bonus answers so that...
Yeah, please raise your hands.
Yes.
It's a very...
I'll come to you.
Disciplined school, we need perfect discipline here.
And I need exercise, so I'll run, no problem.
Please. It's all yours.
I said it is very simple, you don't need to tax your brain. No, you can...